Alright, I'm going to walk through the procedure for fundamentals of colorimetric analysis. I'm going to use unknown 100 in order to do this analysis. We're going to start by preparing a blank cuvette. So the blank cuvette is going to contain DI water. And we do want to make sure that we keep the sides of the cuvette clean by wiping them with DI water. We're going to prepare our unknown cuvette by taking half, or 1.5 milliliters of our unknown, and we're going to use a Eppendorf pipette that is set for 500 microliters, 0.5 milliliters. Push down on the top, that sucks up 500 milliliters, and because we need 1.5 milliliters, we're going to have to do this 3 times. We also need to include 1.5 milliliters of water from our burette. Make sure that that is mixed thoroughly because the top is less diluted than the bottom at this point. So I put a cap on and shake up our unknown. We are also going to need known solutions that we can measure the absorbance of. So I have copper 2 nitrate. I have nickel 2 nitrate, and I have cobalt 2 nitrate. We're going to prepare these the same way that we did our unknown. We do not have a repipetter set up, so I'm going to use my Eppendorf instead. Start with the copper. And I'm going to take 1.5 milliliters of the copper solution. And combine it with 1.5 milliliters of water. Want to mix this thoroughly. The same thing with the nickel. Thank you. NLER cobalt solution. Now we are ready to prepare our instrument. So once we have our instrument connected, this is what we're going to use. Our light source comes from one side and the detector is on the other. We're going to put our samples in the pan. We want to choose absorbance versus wavelength, full spectrum. We're going to click on that and wait for it to warm up. Okay. Once our lamp is warmed up, we can put our blink cuvette in and finish our calibration. We're going to hang on to that blink because we're going to use it again. So now I'm going to start by collecting the spectrum for the cobalt chloride, or cobalt nitrate. I clean it to make sure there's no fingerprints. I put it in so the clear portions of the window are facing the light, and we click collect. Once it has collected for a few seconds, we hit stop, and we can rename this data set as cobalt nitrate. We can take that out. We can put in our copper nitrate. Put it in the path length of the light and hit collect and stop and rename this data set. Finally, the last known solution, we're going to take the nickel, place it into the spectrophotometer, and hit collect, and stop, and rename this data set. Last one that we have to do is our unknown. So take our unknown, we place it into the spectrophotometer, and we hit collect. After a couple seconds, we hit stop, and we rename this data set, unknown 100. Now we're going to work on preparing a calibration curve for this lab to determine the unknown concentration. I've already prepared solutions 1, 2, and 4. I'm going to show you how to prepare solution 3. Again, I do not have repipetter, but I do have my Eppendorf, and so I'm going to take 1 milliliter of our stock 0.25 molar solution. 1 milliliter of it, which is two dispensing twice out of the 0.5 milliliter Eppendorf pipette. We're then going to have to add 2 milliliters of water into the same cuvette. We should now have stock solutions that are in differing concentrations, and the shade also differs. We're going to finish our calibration by putting our blank DI water into our spectrophotometer after we have chosen the absorbance versus wavelength experiment. Finish the calibration. We put the lowest concentration, which is standard one. We add that into our spectrophotometer. We hit collect and stop and rename our data set. We go to solution or standard two. We add that to our spectrophotometer. We hit collect and stop. Rename our data set. Standard two. And we continue on collecting data for the four standards and also our unknown sample. We can use that information then in order to do the calculations and figure out what the diluted concentration is of our unknowns.